In Chapter 3 of this series, we seated some cast lead cores into our brass jackets using the Blackmon core seating die. In Chapter 4, we're going to complete our bullets by performing the final step in the process, point forming. The point forming die set is composed of three pieces, including an ejector, die, and punch. As with the other dies in this kit, a seated core and jacket are forced into the die via a punch, which applies enough pressure to gradually compress and swage one end into a point. Once this is complete, the tiny ejector rod pushes the bullet back out of the die, at which point it's ready to load. To install this die set, we'll begin by removing the ejector retention pin and threading the die and ejector into the ram. With that done, we'll insert the retention pin, ensuring it's lined up with the groove in the ejector. Now we'll install the punch and tighten it in place with the retention nut. As with the other operations, we're going to apply some swage lube to the bullet core and jacket. This time we're going to be extra liberal with it, as the ejector pin is very narrow and can't take the same stress as those used in the previous operations. Now we simply place the seated core and jacket into the die and lower the handle. The incredible amount of force being generated here is gradually forcing the bullet further and further into the die, which becomes progressively narrower. When the press finally bottoms out, we'll raise the handle and eject our completed bullet. As with the other steps, there's initially some adjustment required to get the bullet tip to the desired diameter, but once it's dialed in, point forming becomes a simple process of feeding bullets and operating the press. Although the open tip made by using the ejector rod to form a small hollow point is by far the most popular bullet type, you can also feed them in backwards to make round nose bullets. I generally prefer the hollow points, but the beauty of swaging is you can make them however you like. We'll do a few more so you can get a good look at how both types are made. Let's take a look at the finished product. Here we've got some of the round-nosed version. As you can see, they're very consistent. I've loaded and fired these for years with excellent results. Moving on, we've also got the open tip variety. I swaged some of these to the point where the lead went right to the end, while others were formed with more of an aggressive hollow point at the tip. These expand extremely well and are a lot of fun to shoot. And here's a commercially made full metal jacket bullet for comparison. All four styles load and fly well, and I regularly alternate between them. So what was the final weigh-in? As you might imagine, the point-forming process doesn't really change the weight much, if at all, since that's largely controlled by the core swaging operation. Nonetheless, as you can see, each bullet, including the commercial one, weighs in at 55 grains. That's perfect, since it means I can use them without having to adjust my scopes or sights. Hopefully you found this mini-series interesting. I get a real kick out of making these bullets, so in the future, I'll probably do a video on loading and firing them, as well as some other custom bullets that you can make with this set.